So now, students will continue with lens, the remaining ray diagrams. For convex lens, we had last talk when the object is at 2f1 and you got the image at 2f2, the image and object were same size, so magnification was 1 and we had seen that it is used in a terrestrial telescope. So now we go on to the next part, like the objects are coming closer and closer. The image is being formed according to the position of the object. First we had seen infinity, then we had seen very far away, not infinity. There's not heavenly bodies, but very far away object like the tree. Then we saw object beyond 2f1. Then we took object at 2f1. After that we took between 2f1 and f1. So now we are going to that case, the fourth case, that is object is between 2f1 and f1. So because object is between 2f1 and f1, now we have to see the position of the image. So object AB is erect. What do you mean by erect? Anything above the principal axis is called erect. And anything below the principal axis is called inverted. This we had already learned in standard 9 when we did mirrors also. And same way, the rays are actually meeting at a point after refraction. So that is why it is called real image. Real image is always real inverted. The words go together. Whether it is mirror or it is lens. Real inverted. Those words are always together. And virtual always erect. So here you are getting a real inverted image. We are considering all the three rays. We had seen which rays to consider while drawing ray diagrams. The first ray is a ray parallel to the principal axis. After refraction it passes through F2. The second ray is a ray passing through O. It goes straight, undeviated. And the third ray, we are considering a ray coming from F1. After refraction, it will be parallel to the principal axis. So all these three rays, they are meeting at point B dash. So A dash, B dash is the image of object AB. So now you can see that the size of the image is much more than the size of the object. Image size is more than object size. So the image size being more than object size, therefore the magnification is more than 1. Magnification and all these terms, you will have some sums based on lens. So we have numericals based on lens, and in that you will come across the term magnification. Magnification is nothing but it is the height of the image upon height of object. It is also image distance, this distance, which is denoted by letter V upon object distance, that is this distance U. Distances are all measured from the optical center. So in this case, we have shown all the three rays. In case you are not given in the exam paper that you have to draw all the three rays, you can draw two rays. Any two rays, you can draw these two. The third ray will not be shown. So this is used where? It is used to get a magnified image of the object. So it is generally used in projectors, slide projectors and cinema projectors. You place the transparency inverted so that the image comes erect and it is magnified. So it is used in cinema and slide projectors. So this is the use in cinema and slide projectors. So now case 5, this was case 4, draw all this in your long books, practice this, believe me when you think that you can do it automatically in the exam without even drawing it twice, it is, you are bound to make mistakes. So all the arrows should be shown before refraction and after refraction. Now case 5 is when the object is at F1, so when the object is at F1, there will be two rays only which you can show. Obviously you can't show a ray passing through F1 in this case, so that is not possible. So now the object is moved closer, so now the object is at F1. So as you saw, it was first infinity, then very far away, then beyond 2f1, then at 2f1, then this was between 2f1 and F1, and now it is at F1. Then there are one more case left between F1 and O. So when it is at F1, one ray parallel to the principal axis after refraction will emerge through F2. and the second ray, which is passing through optical center, will go straight undeviated. So in this case, you will have two rays, both of which are parallel to principal axis, parallel to each other. So these two rays, parallel rays, we assume that they meet at infinity. No one has seen that infinity, but when we say rays from the sun are parallel. That is because it is coming from very, very far off, in very far off distance. That is why we say that the rays are parallel. Similarly, these parallel rays will meet at very far off distance. And they will form, see, actually the image is so big. When they meet extremely far away, the image formed will be very big. So here actually you can't show AB, A dash, B dash, the image. So you will just write to infinity. And you will mark the arrows before and after refraction. So here it will come in this manner. A convex lens is used to obtain a parallel beam of light in the collimator of a spectrometer. Spectrometer is used to get a parallel beam of light to obtain the spectrum of visible light and to obtain the electromagnetic spectrum. That is, you will learn in the next chapter in spectrum that you have Wibgeor, parallel ray of light. So to obtain a parallel beam of light, you use an instrument called spectrometer, and collimator is a part of the spectrometer. So you use this position of the convex lens to obtain a parallel beam of light in the collimator of a spectrometer. So now we have one case remaining in convex lens, and then both the cases of concave lens. So first we will finish case 6, which is a very important case that is used in magnifying glass and simple microscope to obtain a magnified but virtual erect image. These all images which we have got now and previously were all inverted because they were all formed below principal axis. Now the sixth case is the only case in convex lens where you will get a virtual erect and magnified image. So it has certain many applications. So we'll see the sixth case now. So now this is a very important figure, and this is also important to understand this, the nature of the image. Here the object is between O and F1. The object AB is placed between O and F1. So the object is AB, it is placed between O and F1. When you draw this figure, it is better to keep the object more close to O than close to F1. Because if you keep it more close to O, the rays will be more inclined, so it will come and fit inside the page. If you keep it very close to F1, what will happen is that the rays will be almost parallel, so then it will go very much behind and it will not fit inside your page. So when you draw this figure, make sure that there is space on the left hand side of the lens, because the image is here. In all the other figures, the image was there, it was inverted. Now in this case, the image is on the left hand side. So leave some more space beyond 2F1, and also ensure that the object AB is kept more close to O than to F1. By doing that, you will ensure that the image is formed anywhere behind F1. It is formed anywhere behind the object itself. It may be anywhere. There is no rule, like if your school textbook shows that it is beyond 2F1, that is also okay. If it happens to come, the image happens to fall at 2F1, that is also okay. If it is very much far away beyond 2F1, that is also okay. If it is coming somewhere closer, that is also okay. But only thing is, it will be behind the object. The image will be formed anywhere behind the object and it will be magnified. It will be virtual erect and magnified. Why virtual? Because the rays, this parallel ray is going this way. This ray through optical center is going this way. So these rays are diverging rays. They are not actually meeting. So because they are not actually meeting, it is only these rays produced backward appear to come from B dash. So your image is B dash, A dash. So that's the reason why your image is virtual erect. Virtual because the rays are not actually meeting. They appear to meet at B dash when produced back. And it is virtual erect. Virtual erect and magnified. So that is what is written, image is virtual erect and magnified. And you can also say and it is found anywhere behind the object, and it is formed behind the object on same side. So it is formed behind the object on the same side. Now you have, in this case, size of image is greater than size of object. So again, magnification, magnitude, value will be more than one because it is magnified image. But now in this case, the magnification is positive because the image is erect. Whereas in all the previous cases like concave, convex lens, all of them the image was inverted. So magnification value will be whatever I had shown, like if it is same size, magnification is 1. But then because it is inverted, it will be minus. So minus stands for inverted and plus stands for erect. So here that is what is written. Also erect image, so magnification will be positive. So magnification in this case is positive because the image is erect, and it is greater than 1 because the image is magnified. So instead of telling all this, the object is between O and F1, they may just tell you that draw the ray diagram to show the image of a convex lens which is used as a reading glass, magnifying glass, simple microscope. So all of them is the same thing. It is used to magnify, and reading glass, can the image be inverted? Can you read? No. So it has to be erect. So reading glass, magnifying glass, simple microscope, image for convex lens, if you are asked, you have to draw this diagram. Also, sometimes the question asked is, the image formed by a lens is virtual, erect and magnified. Identify the lens and then draw the image. So in that case, when you get virtual, erect, magnified, then in that case we have to know that it is convex lens. This lens is convex lens. Like you can draw the line and all the refractions, we don't show two refractions. The lens is very thin, so we show the refraction from the center. This curves you can draw using your compass also. A small curve you can show. If the curves are not coming proper, then you can use your compass and pencil and draw. All figures has to be drawn in pencil. In your school exams, and even I will not give you marks if you draw the figures with pen. That is a rule. In Bombay Scottish, they have given 0 when figure is drawn with pen, even in power. So students, please remember, all figures, any diagrams has to be in pencil and neatly drawn and labeled. Now one more thing you will have to see here is when we go to concave lens now. Now we'll start with the new type of lens, that is concave lens. Convex was converging. Why is it called converging? Because parallel ray will go through focus. So it is converging, all the rays are coming closer. And if you have parallel rays like this, you knew that all of them will meet at the focus. Concave lens is diverging. So now this lens, that is the concave lens, is diverging. So if you have a parallel beam of light, parallel to principal axis, it diverges and appears to come from the focus. So parallel ray diverges and appears to come from the focus F2. So that is shown there. Then second ray, you have a ray directed towards the focus. See, don't forget the nature of the concave lens. Concave lens is diverging lens. So you have to remember this. Concave is diverging. That means a ray parallel will go away. A ray moving towards the focus will go away. So here, the ray is directed towards the focus, and that ray will come parallel to principal axis. Common mistake that student makes, this is concave lens, and then if the diagram is shown like this, this is focus, ray is passing through focus, then in that case, some students show it like this. This is wrong, because this means the ray which was going away is made to come parallel. That is not the case. This is wrong. You can't draw this way. In this case, the ray is only directed towards the focus, so it was always already going towards the principal axis. And that ray is made to diverge and move parallel. So this idea means something which is going away is made to come parallel. That would make it what lens? It would make it a converging lens. And it is not a converging lens. Concave lens is diverging lens. So the basic funda of the concave lens, that it is a diverging lens, will not change. So this diagram is wrong. You cannot draw it this way. You have to show the ray directed towards the focus and then coming parallel. So that is what you have to show. So please understand what is wrong and what is right. The third ray, obviously, in convex lens also we showed three rays. One parallel, and after parallel it was going through the focus. And in this case, it is diverging and appearing to come from the focus. Now even see one more thing. Now F1 and F2 is on that side, and F2 is on this side. So F1 is on the right hand side for concave lens. Here it was F1 and F2 was on the left hand side. So that we had already seen when we had defined the first focal length and second focal length for both convex and concave lens. So these three diagrams, the third is very simple. It is similar to what you had learned in convex lens. A ray of light which is passing through the optical center travels undeviated. So you can use 1, 2, 3 rays to form the image. One ray, second ray, first ray parallel to principal axis, diverging and appearing to come from F2. Second ray passing through F1, parallel to principal axis. Third ray passing through O, going undeviated. So these three rays can be considered while drawing ray diagrams for concave lens, which is diverging lens. So now we will continue with the, there are not six figures, but only two figures for a concave lens, the ray diagrams. So we will see that now. So ray diagrams for concave lens. Now when you show the concave lens, the first ray diagram is object is at infinity. So when object is at infinity, you are having parallel rays which are parallel to principal axis. So this is exactly how you had shown for convex lens also. When it's very far away and in infinity. Infinity means the rays are parallel to principal axis. Those rays will diverge and appear to come from the focus F2. So in this case, the focus F2 is this side. So you will be showing it diverging and coming from the focus. Whereas if the object is far away, not infinity, but very far away, like I told you, when we had convex lens, we were talking about the image of a tree, which may be around 20 meters or 50 meters in front of your house or in front of your science lab. So though that tree is not infinity, the tree is far away. Whereas the stars and the moon and all is far away. That is infinity. Star, moon and all you will call infinity. Whereas the tree in front of your house is far away. So in this case the rays are parallel, but they are not parallel to principal axis. So in this case you will show, first you will draw this ray. That is a ray directed towards F1. After refraction it will come parallel to principal axis. So a ray directed towards F1. After refraction coming parallel to principal axis, and that ray has to be produced behind. And another ray you have to show, which is passing through optical center going straight undeviated. So those two rays with arrows are shown. Now the point of intersection, this has to be produced behind, and where it meets the ray which is passing through optical center, that will be a point on F2 on the focal plane. Focal plane means what? The vertical line passing through F2. That is the focal plane of F2. So you are getting inverted, virtual, erect and diminished image. It's virtual, erect and it is not a magnified image. The object may be the sun. So that is huge. This is a diminished image. So virtual, erect and diminished image. Understand one thing, that in concave lens, the image wherever it may be is always diminished. So virtual erect and diminished is concave. virtual erect and magnified is the last case which we saw of convex lens object between F1 and O. So this is used in Galilean telescope in this manner. And the last ray diagram for lens, in this case you have the object is anywhere in front of the concave lens. Anywhere in front means now whether it is here just beyond 2F1 or it is at 2F1 or it is between F2 and 2F2 or whether the object is at F2 makes no difference. For all of that we have just one ray diagram. In this case we are showing the object AB is just shown just beyond 2F2. So whether it is at 2F2 or at just beyond 2F2 this doesn't make any difference for this particular lens, that is concave lens. Yes, of course, it made a hell of a difference in convex lens. So we had 6 different ray diagrams. Here there is only, this is infinity, far away, like the tree in front of your house. This is far away. This is the sun or stars. And this is something which is very close. So here, one ray through optical center going undeviated. Second ray, parallel to principal axis after refraction, concave lens, diverging lens, it moves away, but appears to come from F2. These two rays, this ray and they actually don't meet, but this ray when produced backward, appears to meet this ray B, O, that ray at point B dash. So B dash, A dash is the image. Now in this concave lens, since you are getting only virtual image, your image has to be shown dotted. Virtual images are dotted. If you don't show it dotted, you lose one mark in the ray diagram. So here also this B dash A dash is dotted. Here also your A dash B dash is dotted. So in this case, it is dotted image. Even in the convex lens last diagram between O and F1, where you got virtual erect and magnified for the simple microscope or reading glass, that image is dotted. So all these images which are dotted means it is virtual image. So virtual erect, in this case it is virtual, it is erect. Erect because it is above the principal axis and it is diminished. And image will be formed between O and F2. Always the image will be formed between O and F2. So it is used for short-sightedness in spectacle lens. It is used for treatment of myopia, that is short-sightedness. And remember, virtual images must always be shown dotted. Now we will continue with the Cartesian sign conventions for doing sums based on lens. Students, we will continue with the sign conventions of lens and lens formula. So first let's see the sign conventions. They are extremely simple. No need to read everything that is given in the textbook, just follow this. It makes things very simple, it is not complex. First of all, this looks so much like the graph. So it is exactly like the graph only. Every rule in the graph is the same here also. See, in the graph you had origin, now you have optical center. So the origin is given a new name, optical center. In the graph, all distances, whatever points you are plotting, the distances are taken from the origin. In this case, all distances are measured from the optical center. So this, instead of x-axis, now that is the principal axis. So in lens, that is the principal axis. So you have the same rules. If you are taking a distance from optical center to the object or image, wherever, if optical center to image distance you are taking and it's on the right of the lens, this y-axis is actually the lens. So you can consider this, you can call this line as principal axis and this line to be the lens, the center of the lens. So now in this case, all distances to the right of the optical center is positive. It is like x-axis also, all distances there on the right of zero was positive, on the right of the origin was positive. All distances measured from optical center to the left will be always negative. So now understand one thing, object in all the diagrams, whether it was concave lens or convex lens, always as per convention, we have always placed the object to the left of the lens. So that is why always the object distance is denoted by small u. Now don't ask me whether it is initial velocity. We are doing light chapter, so it is not initial velocity. That was 9th standard in motion chapter. In this chapter, small u stands for object distance. So object distance is distance from optical center to the object. You will start from optical center and then move, not object to optical center. The distance may be the same, but you are measuring everything from optical center to that point. So optical center to object, that distance is small u, and because object is always on the left hand side of the lens, that is why it is always going to be negative. So when they say that an object is placed 30 centimeter on the left of the lens or in front of the lens, so that means u is minus 30 centimeter. In front means this side is considered front of the lens and that side is considered behind the lens. So you will come across these words very commonly in the sums. This side, all this is called front of the lens. And that side, on that side is called behind the lens. So object is always placed in front of the lens. It is on the left hand side. So object distance small u is always negative. All distances are measured from optical center. Now image distance is denoted by small v. I had explained a little bit of that when I was doing the ray diagrams of convex lens, so that I just wanted you to just get used to some terms like magnification. So I had explained what is u and v in one of the diagrams, and I had also explained you what is height of image and height of object. And we had written the formula of magnification also. So now image you cannot take always positive or always negative. Now image, it depends where the image is formed. See, if it's a virtual image, it will be formed on the same side as the object. So virtual image, that means the last case of convex lens and all the cases in concave lens. There is only two cases in concave lens. So only if the image is virtual and erect, in that case V also will be negative because we will be on this side. Image will be formed on this side. So image distance will be negative, object distance is always negative. But if the image is real and inverted, so that means the image is real, the rays are actually going to meet. The first five cases, all the first five cases except the last case of convex lens. So in all those cases, the image will be formed on that side and it will be formed below the principal axis. So if the image is, let's say, formed here, let's consider a real inverted image is formed here. Let's say this is A dash, B dash. Then in that case, this distance from the optical center will be denoted by V, and that distance will be negative, positive, because it is on the right hand side of the optical center. So distances on the right will be always positive and distances on the left will be negative. So virtual erect image means V is negative, and real inverted image means V is positive. So now, as you already know, this is optical center. This is the optical center. So we cannot say directly that V is always going to be negative or positive. You have to be careful when you read the question. If V is virtual erect, that means V is on this side, so V will be negative. And if V is real inverted, first five cases of convex lens, if it is real inverted, it will be like this on this side, so V will be positive. So V, whether it is positive or negative, depends on the nature of the image, whereas u, that is optic distance, is always going to be negative, because in all cases the object is placed on the left hand side, that is in front of the lens. I hope that is very clear. Now we have focal length. Focal length of a convex lens is always taken to be positive, whereas focal length of a concave lens is always taken to be negative. So that is sign convention. So parallel rays meet at the focus, so that focal length of convex lens is always taken to be convex lens positive, concave lens negative. So that's exactly what is around written here. Sign conventions of lens can easily be understood by following the same conventions as the graph. For the lens, the optical center O. The optical center O is the origin. Object is always considered to be placed on the left of the lens. So object is always on the left of the lens. And so object distance from origin, the object distance means distance of object from origin. So this distance of origin to object, this distance is denoted by u, small u, and it is always negative, because it is on the left. Just follow the sign conventions of graph. So if the image is real and inverted, then it will be on the right hand side of the lens. So real inverted image like this, then the image will be on the right hand side of the lens, and the image distance from the optical center, that is V, this distance will be taken as positive. So on that side it is positive. If the image is virtual erect, so image is found here, like you had simple microscope or reading glass, the image was virtual erect image formed here. So in that case the image distance will be negative, and that image distance would be taken as negative because it is virtual erect. So image is virtual erect, then the image will be on the left hand side of the lens, that is on the same side of the object. So in this case the image distance small v will be taken to be negative. Then about focal length. For a convex lens, small f, that is focal length, principal focus was capital F. So focal length f, small f, for a focal length is always positive for convex lens. And for a concave or diverging lens, focal length is always negative. So sometimes they don't tell convex and concave. Instead of convex, they say converging lens. And instead of concave, they say diverging lens. All heights, so any height which is measured above the principal axis is always taken as positive. So height of object, so this height what is measured here from the principal axis is denoted by capital O. Don't confuse it with optical center. Capital O, height of object, is always taken to be positive. Why? Because it is above the principal axis. And height of image may be positive or negative. If it is virtual erect image, like here you have image which is virtual erect. So if A dash B dash is virtual erect image, then height of image, this height. Heights are always measured from principal axis. So that height will be taken to be positive. Whereas if it is like this, below the principal axis, this is also image. But this is an image which is formed for convex lens when it is real inverted image. So such heights below the principal axis will be taken as negative. So all heights above principal axis is always positive, and all heights taken below the principal axis is always negative. So now these are some basic sign conventions. 3-mark board, in the board exam, 3-mark sum could be asked which is based on it. No one will ask you this all by heart. There will be some answer on it, or they may just give that the focal length of a concave lens is 20 cm and find the power of the lens with the correct sign. So when they say such a thing, you should know that it is concave lens, so focal length is not just 20. It has to be taken as minus 20. So the power also will be negative. So we will go ahead and we will see the lens formula and what is power of the lens. So now we will see the lens formula. the lens formula. Now forget the mirror formula because that was 9th standard. So don't confuse the mirror formula and lens formula. Lens formula only keep it in mind. 1 by F is 1 by V minus 1 by U. So this is the formula that you will use in 10th standard for all lens related sums. F stands for focal length of the lens. As already told, for convex lens, it is positive, and for concave lens, F will be negative. So even in the question, you are told that the concave lens focal length is 20 cm. You have to take it as minus 20. It may not be given in the question that it is minus 20, but it is mentioned it is a concave lens, and it has focal length 20 cm. Which means when you substitute the value in the formula, you will not take it as 20, we will have to take it as minus 20 because it was concave lens with focal length 20 cm. Now V. V is the distance of the image from the optical center. So from optical center, if that is the image, V from O to A dash, that distance is V. Now V, as we already told you, it can be positive or it can be negative. If it is on that side, like this image, this is what image? Real inverted image. If it is real inverted image, it is positive. If it is virtual erect image, it is negative. So V, you have to decide based on the sum whether you will take it as positive or negative. If it is real inverted image like that figure, then in that case it will be positive because it's on the right of optical center. Whereas if it is a virtual erect image, you will take V as negative. So you have to check and see what is mentioned in the sum before you put the sign for V. For everything you have to put sign, plus or minus, whether it is F, V or U. Now U is simple. U is always on this side, this is the object. So this distance from optical center to point A, this distance, horizontal distance, that is U. So U is always negative. So whether it is convex lens or concave lens, given that the object is placed 40 cm in front of the lens, so the object distance is not 40, it is minus 40, whatever may be the lens. So U is always negative. So that you have to use this formula with the correct sign. 1 by F is 1 by V minus 1 by U is the lens formula. Then you have the basic formula and definition of linear magnification. Now magnification means whether the image is big, same size or small. So that is the idea of magnification. The formula is length or height of image. So here this is the image, height. So A dash, B dash, vertically. That is the image height. Don't confuse height of image with distance of image. Distance of image, that is small v, that is optical center to A dash. This is the height or length of the image, that is A dash, B dash. And length or height of object, that is AB, that is length or height of object. So you will find that object is always placed on top of the principal axis. So you will always get object height will be taken as positive. Now image height, that is I, whether you have to take it as positive or negative will depend on whether the image formed is real inverted. In this case it is real inverted, so it is below the principal axis. So I will be negative. Whereas if I, let's say you have simple microscope case, or any case of a concave lens where you have virtual erect and diminished image formed between OMF, in those two cases when the image is virtual and erect, in that case height of image will be positive. So that's mentioned here, height of object O is always positive, as always object is above the principal axis. Height of image capital I is negative if the image is real and inverted like this. Height of image I will be positive if the image is virtual erect, that means dotted image and virtual erect. So based on that you will get magnification as positive or negative. This denominator O is always positive, If the image is virtual erect, then magnification will have a plus sign. So plus sign of magnification means something. It means that the image is virtual and erect. And minus sign in front of the numerical value of magnification would mean that the image is real inverted like this. So you have to be careful what the plus and minus sign means. I'm not talking about the number after the plus and the minus sign. I'm just telling you about the plus and minus sign's meaning. Plus sign indicates that the image formed is virtual erect. And minus sign indicates that the image formed is real inverted. So that is the meaning of plus and minus. Now we will see what is the numerical value given to m, small m. What does that mean? If numerical value is less than 1, for example, let's say the numerical value is 0.5. 0.5 is less than 1. That means that the size of the image is less than the size of the object. Or in other words, it means that the image is small, diminished. It's a diminished image when you compare it with the object. M is equal to 1 means object and image is same size. Object and image is same size, that is when M is equal to 1. Can you remember the case? Yes, when convex lens we were using. And in convex lens, you were getting the object at 2f. Then the image was of the same size and it was formed at 2f2 on the other side. So the same size. So magnification value in that case will be 1. Now in that case, would it be plus 1 or minus 1? It would be minus 1. Why would it be minus? The minus sign is because the image formed would be real inverted at 2f2. So that is why in that particular case, when the object and image is same size, you got m is 1. But the plus minus sign is for whether the image is real inverted, virtual erect or real inverted. Real inverted it would be minus, virtual erect it would be plus. Now if m is greater than 1, it means that the image is magnified. So m is greater than 1 can never be the case in concave lens. In concave lens always you have diminished image. So m is greater than 1 you will have cases in case of concave lens. In case of convex lens, m greater than 1 means the image is bigger than the object. So these are two formulae that are used. Now we will see an extension of this. Instead of I upon O, you can say it is V upon U. There are derivations given in concise, but it is clearly mentioned, it is not there in the syllabus. So you don't have to learn any of those derivations. All this, I upon O is equal to V upon U is from congruency. So you just have to remember the formula. Magnification is height of image upon height of object. And I will write in the next frame that is also equal to V upon U, where V stands for distance of image from optical center and U stands for distance of object from optical center. So please note all this down, because all this will be used in the sums. So M is equal to I upon O, which is also equal to V upon U. V is image distance from optical center, U is object distance from optical center. All this derivation is not there in the syllabus, you don't have to bother about it. Power of the lens. Now power of the lens means, let's say you have a convex lens, parallel rays, and that lens is very powerful. That means the focal length will be less. The convergence will be very sharp. It will focus very nearby, close to the lens. Whereas if it has less power, then that means the focal length will be more. So if the focal length is more, the power will be less. So power of the lens, if they ask you derivation, then write the whole thing. Don't just write the formula, write the deviation of the incident light rays produced by a lens on refraction through it is a measure of the power. That means if you have parallel rays of light and let's say it is a convex lens, so it is converging. If it converges very close to the optical center, that means it's a very powerful lens. If the convergence is less, that means it will be having a much greater focal length. So the deviation means how much it has bent. The deviation of the incident rays of light produced by a lens on refraction through it is a measure of its power. An SI unit of power of lens is diopter. Remember, this has also been asked, what is the SI unit? D-I-O-P-T-R-E. It is denoted by alphabet capital D. So, when they ask you definition, write this and also mention this. Power of a lens in diopter is 1 upon focal length in meter. So, the focal length of the lens has to be converted to meter. For example, let's say the lens has focal length of 20 centimeter convex lens. So, plus 20 centimeter, you have to convert it and write it as plus 0.2 meter. So, what would be the power? 1 upon 0.2, that is 5 diopter, and that too will be plus. Convex lens power will be plus. So, it will come plus 5 diopter. So, remember 20 centimeter, you have to convert the centimeter to meter. So, it will be plus 0.2 meter. So, for convex lens, both focal length and power are positive. See, now convex lens is the lens which is used in long-sightedness for treatment of long-sightedness or hypermetropia. So, for long-sightedness, which lenses use convex lens? So, the people, if they say that the power of my lens is 1 diopter and it is positive, means that person is using convex lens and it is used for long-sightedness. And then concave lens is used for myopia or short-sightedness. Now concave lens, it will have focal length and power both negative. So if the person says the power of my eye lens or my spectacles is minus 2 diopter, that means the person is suffering from myopia or short-sightedness. You can remember the word easily. Short-sightedness, the word is short, myopia. And long-sightedness, the word itself is long, hypermetropia. So note, the two thin lens, if you have two or three thin lens placed together as a combination, if they have an individual power of P1 and P2, and if they are placed together, then the power of the combination will be the sum of the power of the two lens with correct sign. So when you take the power of combination, you will have to take the sign of the individual powers also. For example, if a convex lens has power of plus 5D and a concave lens has power of minus 3D. So convex lens, obviously the power is positive and concave lens power is negative. So combination will be adding up the two with the sign. So plus 5D plus minus 3D. So it will be plus 2D. So that means the combination will behave as a convex lens because it is having plus power. It will behave as a convex lens or converging lens with a net power of 2D. So you will have to find the power of the combination this way. So that is all about lens and the theory part. So now next we will, in the next video session, we will do the sums based on lens. The sums and numericals based on all this. So copy all this in your notebooks and read this and learn this first before doing the sums.